Hi there, my name's Jason Williams, and in this video, I'm just a real quick random video about turning a seat. This is an old like racing seat, or you know, just it's a sus, nice comfy seat. Anyway, it used to be in buggies and what are they called? Odysseys. I used to live in a few different places, and we're cleaning up a shed, helping a mate move across to his new place. And he's like, "Oh, I've got all this stuff. I'll just throw it out." And I'm like, "You're not going to throw this out anyway." So I salvaged it, and I'm going to make it my workshop chair. So I've got an old frame off an office chair that hopefully it's still okay. Got a base, I've got to shape that in and make it a bit better and mount it to this, give this a bit of clean up, carpet the base, and you know, I'll just do that to basically recycle this, otherwise it'd be waste going into the tip. So this is a good way to recycle things that are old, no longer wanted, but you know, keep it useful. All right, so what I'm gonna do is begin, and I'm gonna shape up the base, neaten it up, and begin mounting this. Cool. I'll have a nice work chair. I've got an office chair, but they don't last very long. They get destroyed. I mean, this has got a couple of welding holes in it from welding, and it'll still be all right. And we'll see how it goes. So basically, I've got here, I've just got a disc. I've cut this, you know, relative to size and drilled a few holes, but just going to chamfer them with the jigsaw, you know, cut them, like smooth them out so that when I carpet it, it'll hopefully look half decent. Let's do that. Try this on for size. All right, that'll do for that. I've now got to cut a piece of this, give it a bit of a clean, and glue it to that, and use a staple gun to get it around the edges. So let's cut that and make that work. Alright, with that cut, you know, I'm just going to test it for fitment here. And a bit how you go. It needs a vacuum. I'll vacuum it once I've installed it. But I have to clean the base according to the glue, because I will glue this and staple it. So I just give it a little bit of a wipe, make sure there's no oil debris or anything on it. And that'll do. And the same goes for the carpet. I don't know how I'm supposed to clean this old carpet, but I'll do something similar. Can't imagine this is doing very much, but either way, I'll see if it works. With that, like so, get it roughly central on there. Knowing that I'm going to be folding this over. What's that gonna look like for the corners? I don't think I'll even need to trim that. I'll just glue it and staple it, mate. Yeah, it'll be when I glue it, and I'll just pull it and staple it, clamp it, pull it, staple it, clamp it. That'll be the go. So in that case, I can now begin to glue it. See, I haven't even, like, you know, looked. Ooh, how do I use this glue? Because I'm no upholsterer. Yeah, it's clean. Brush it on. You wait 20 to 40 minutes. What? It says, using applicator, completely cover both sides. Adhesive surface, touch dry, approximately 20 minutes, no more than 40. All right, so what I'll do is do it till it's quite touch dry. All right. And now it says to mix this up properly, thoroughly. Oh, I'm not seeing any changes in the viscosity or colour or anything, so I'm not sure what I'm trying to achieve with the mixing. But either way, it says to mix it, so till the stuff's quite uniform, and I'll tell you what, it's already uniform. Before I even started mixing, there's nothing out of the ordinary going on here. Well, since that's the case, I'll just go ahead and put a bit on. That's what you get when you live in a warm climate. Look at that, that's almost drying as I, you know, that is drying. There's not going to be any waiting around for this. It's going to be waxed straight on there. It's going tacky already. Oh. That's so quite fast. Oh well. Don't think it was meant to be that quick, but oh well. And okay. Hope I've got enough staples right. In the staple gun. Never done this before. Just as a first for everything, right? I'm going to try this and see if this can go right through all of them. Doubt it, but yeah, it did. As it's folded over, it just stapled it down. Go to the staple gun. With that done, I can probably locate these holes, wherever they are. Who's that? One there, didn't it? Or does it? No, that wasn't even close. Yeah, that's more like it. All right. That's that and that. I can grab this chair, mount this on. That's it. That's that bit. All right. Now the last section of this, which is super simple, right? Well, you would think. And what's going to happen here is this toggle has to be to the front of the seat, and this has to be accessed by the right hand, which is at this point. All right. And if I get a tape measure, I'm pretty sure the base has to be central. So if I've got 50 mil there, I've got like 75, go 60, all right, 60, We'll try at that end. I mean, even that'll be, yep, 60. 120. 120. 120. How'd I get that spot on in the middle? Anyone think I've done this before? Change that out. I've even got some busted ass old tech screws that I'm just going to reuse. Lined up with some holes I'd put in there. How'd I get that? I think I fluked that. Yep, not on this one. There we go. Jagged it. And again. No, I did feel with the end of the screw for the hole with the indent in the would be. Might be. Lucky last. Cool. That's it. Either way, I've just made a really awesome cat's chair because my cat seems to want to be on, you know, she sits on this. So I come in every morning in the shed and there's a cat sleeping on my chair. It's like, oh, typical. But anyway, yes, thank you very much for watching. Strange little video, another random one. And I will, you know, I'll aspire to see you in the next one. Cheers, thanks for watching. Ta.